Hey, what's up, you guys? I'm out here at Universal Studios Hollywood today. Check out some of the updates on Secret Life of Pets because it's so close to opening Jurassic World and Super Nintendo World. So let's go check it out. Looks like they finally opened back up the Fountain Plaza area in the upper lot. This was closed for a little bit. They were just taking down Lunar New Year or what, but it's open. If you have kids, you can now run through water. I just noticed there's literally a warning sign for the fountains. Hello? I'm waiting for like the pregnant mothers can't ride. LOL. And then sadly, here's what remains of Walking Dead, as Walking Dead has officially closed here at Universal Studios Hollywood. Now they did mention that it is closed for normal park operations. Obviously there's a huge construction wall in front of it, but it is gonna be reopening for Horror Nights this year. They let that slip. So if you were missing Walking Dead, it'll be open for Horror Nights, I guess. And then in the new Secret Life of Pets area, the gift shop is open. Exciting things are happening. Oh my goodness. Obviously, there is a ton of Secret Life of Pets character merch. You have Max, Snowball, the other pets, you know, the other pet names, besides Max and Snowball. I'll be honest, I'm not a huge fan of Secret Life of Pets, but Dark Rides, they got me there. There's a bunch of Snowball merch, a backpack, bunny ears, t-shirts. So basically this is kind of like a Duffy situation where you can adopt a pup. So you pick your pup and then you can get its own carrying case, its own little scarf, and you can customize your own little pup. And of course this is the exit of the ride, so the ride is happening just up there. I can hear it. Oh my god. And then here is the front that we've seen before, but they added Max to the sign. Look at him just sitting up there. Honestly, I don't know if that's safe for him to be up there, but you know, it's fine, I guess. And if you have not heard, Secret Life of Pets is a virtual queue. So to get in line, you'll do virtual tickets, which is right over here. So you'll scan your pass or ticket and you'll get a return time to come back to ride it. Therefore, you don't have to wait in line. Orlando uses this technology for Jimmy Fallon and Fast and the Furious, so it'll be the first time it'll be used here, which is exciting. Ooh, some newspaper theming. City finally fishes animal control truck out of river. Oh my god. I'm trying to figure out if it's on this side, or maybe in the front, or maybe on the other side, but there's supposed to be a window where there'll be an animatronic puppet Snowball, which is the rabbit character that Kevin Hart voices, that will interact with guests down here. So he's in a window. I just don't know which one. Maybe on the left side. This window looks like it could be drawn open. I just don't know. I feel like they wouldn't want to cause people to stand right in front of the entrance, so I don't see the window being over there. I feel like it'd be more on this side. You know what? This McGuff Cinema has a Snowball poster and a Secret Life of Pets 2 poster, but has a very large window. I feel like this might be the Snowball window. Yeah, if you look down like all the buildings, this building has the biggest window and it has a poster for Snowball right under it. And the curtains are different. Like those are yellow and white and then those are all white up there. I don't know. This might be it, y'all. One of my favorite Easter eggs in the Secret Life of Pets area is every window front has a Protected by Cyberdyne sticker, which is, if you don't know, the company from Terminator, Cyberdyne. So it's a little nod because Terminator used to be in this area. It's what Minions kind of took over. Village Bikes. Ooh, bike night. Thrift store sale, but guess what? Protected by Cyberdyne, this whole city. Wow. They already have some team members out in some of the uniforms and they kind of look like New York pet crossing guards.
What's exciting though, if you have not seen, Inside Universal just released some on-ride photos, and as you can see, there are a lot of animatronics. Universal said there are 64 animatronics in this ride, so if you were ever worried about screens or projections, we are finally getting like a true Universal dark ride, and it's very exciting. You can see the test seats, the car, the vehicle, our little cardboard boxes. Very cute. I'm very excited to ride this ride. And if you have not heard, things are getting actually super real because Universal finally announced the opening date for Secret Life of Pets is March 27th, the end of this month. However, if you're an annual pass holder previews start actually this Saturday. Universal Hollywood sent out a link and email on their Twitter. If you're an annual pass holder, you should have got a link to sign up for a day. Saturday just happens to be the first day, but there's a couple dates and a couple times, so you have to sign up for a day and time. You can't just come if you're an annual pass holder. So definitely check that out if you want to ride the ride before it opens at the end of this month. But that's really it for the updates over here in the Secret Life of Pets area. I can't believe it's already like starting previews on Saturday. I'm very excited. I'm excited that Universal finally has like a dark ride, and I just, anything with like a bunch of animatronics, I'm here for it. Anyway, let's go check out some other things.
Came over to Super Silly Funland to check out what's happening with Gru's Lab Cafe. And obviously there is a brand new paint job, all yellow. It's definitely gonna be full on like Minions Cafe now. There's Minions all over the front now, in the windows and straight up on the buildings. Look how cute they are. Like little Twinkies. I'm calling it right now. They just made this wall right here for people to take Instagram pictures for. This is the official Minion wall. Come get it.
Popped on over to the Wizarding World because I just wanted to let you guys know this is not like super new news, but just last month they brought over Fishy Green Ale from Diagon Alley to here in California. So if you've never tried Fishy Green Ale, it's now here. Personally, I hate Fishy Green Ale. If you don't know what it is, it's like a minty cinnamony drink with blueberry boba at the bottom. It looks like seawater and fish eggs, hence Fishy Green Ale. But after all the drinks they could have brought over for Diagon Alley, they could have brought like Otter's Fizzy Lifting Orange Juice or Lemon Squash. They brought Fishy Green Ale, so not my favorite. But if you want to try it, it's here. And here we are in front of the ever-changing Jurassic World. Still very much dry.
Last time I was here, there was a little water in it, but now there's zero water at all. We still have no opening date for when she'll come back up, but I'm being optimistic because if you look up here, we got the Jurassic World sign back. If you don't remember, this came down for a little bit, but she's back up. She's looking good. At least we got some exterior going on. Very exciting.
I can only assume Jurassic World will be back up in April for like spring break, or perhaps they could surprise us and do like end of March for like Secret Life of Pets and Jurassic World, double whammy, bring people in. But yeah, my guess is April. There's no official date yet, so these are just rumors, but I'm excited when she does open back up to see the upgrade. She's not even a year old and we're already getting an upgrade to her, so yeah. I'm excited to check it out. Hopefully it's even scurrier. Like if the Indominus lunges at me, it's already a win. Like the Indominus can have my body for nourishment. I'm willing to give that up, you know?
However, just because Jurassic World is closed doesn't mean the fun has to stop. We got cornhole out here, y'all. Oh my God. I turned the corner to the bathrooms and hello, Nintendo World Construction. You are getting close. Excuse me while I scream over all the Jurassic Park music, but it looks like these are definitely like temporary walls to like keep all the construction dust and stuff away from guests and whatnot, but yeah, it's getting closer. I still feel like this will be one of the main entrances. I'm calling it now. Not much is happening on the Transformers side. I feel like this gate got lower though, so that's fun. Just more enclosure on the main building that's still rumored to be Mario Kart. Probably a bay door right here, but nothing much visually. Sooner or later, this is gonna be all enclosed and we're not gonna see anything for a lot. But Yeah, not too much.
However, there have been some new details, especially regarding the power-up bands that are supposed to be in the Super Nintendo World. Now, these are similar to like magic wands, where it's an extra purchase and you'll be able to do interactive things within the entire area. But my friend Alicia over at Theme Park Stop did a full video on what we can expect from collecting coins to badges to actually doing like multiplayer boss battles. It's gonna be pretty intense. But if you'd like to check that video out, I'll put a link right there. I'm very excited. I already know I want a Yoshi one. Not only is this green, but Yoshi's probably one of my favorite characters. So if you want to like join my Super Mario Party now to kill Bowser in these boss battles, get ready. I know I'm like a year early, but I'm here for it. I'm serious. Anyway, thank you guys for joining me around Universal Studios Hollywood today. And stay tuned for my thoughts and opinions on Secret Life of Pets, as I will be riding it this Saturday. Very much looking forward to that. And if you have not subscribed yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell to know when I upload next and to learn about all the different updates around the parks in California. And if you want to support me even more, check out my Patreon link in the description below. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you real soon.